Debian dot vdi. So just copy it to your machine and download VirtualBox.
We need VirtualBox.
We need VirtualBox.
ये वर्चुअल बॉक्स वाली चीज अच्छी नहीं थी
वर्चुअल बॉक्स वाली चीज अच्छी
नहीं थी जैसा ओपन सोर्स वर्जन है
या एंड वर्चुअल बॉक्स इटसेल्फ इज ओपन सोर्स इट्स डेवलप्ड बाय ओरेकल एंड इट्स ओपन
या ये सर इट इज अ लाइक वर्चुअल
बॉक्स वर्चुअल की अच्छी नहीं लगती
ओके सो शुड वी स्टार्ट गाइस So we are going to take a session on OpenStack. So first we'll introduce ourselves. So I'm Akanksha and she's Sana, and we both have graduated from College of Engineering Pune in 2014, and we interned last year with RailsGirl Summer of Code. So we worked on Rubinius as a part of RailsGirl Summer of Code, and right now I'm interning with OpenStack as a part of Outreachy. So this is on our agenda today. So we'll tell you what is OpenStack. We'll tell you what are the major components of OpenStack. We'll tell you what is DevStack, that is a development environment used by beginner OpenStack developers. And then we'll see everything in action. We'll install DevStack and we'll see. We'll spawn an instance of a VM and we'll see everything in action, whatever we study. So the question here is, what is OpenStack? So OpenStack is basically a cloud operating system. So it is a virtualization platform which enables you to control everything like launch a VM and then scale it to whatever extent you want. You can scale up, you can scale down, and you can it's all virtually. And It is all controlled through a dashboard, that is the Horizon dashboard, which we are going to see. So what OpenStack does is it abstracts everything like compute, storage and networking, which are the three major components we need in case of virtualization, from the underlying hardware. So we'll see the major components of OpenStack. So these are the major components of OpenStack. There are many more components, but these are the components which you need to understand in order to understand what the brief overview about OpenStack. So the first component is Horizon, that is the dashboard. It is basically a web application which is used for accessing all the services which OpenStack provides. Now what OpenStack provides is you can launch an instance in the VM, you can configure network, and you can configure clusters. You can do anything as in cloud infrastructure using OpenStack. So the second is Keystone. So Keystone is an authentication service which is used by all the other services of OpenStack as well. So so you can access all the services on the OpenStack, but you'll have to get it authenticated by Keystone first. So even if you want to access Horizon, so Keystone will authenticate you and then you can get through the Horizon dashboard. The third most important component is Nova. So Nova is basically the heart of OpenStack. It does everything. So when you say launch an instance on the OpenStack cloud, it is Nova API which gets the request, and it then passes the request to every other services in the OpenStack. So we'll see using an example what it does. Next we have Glance. So Glance is an image registry. So the VMs require virtual images. So the images are not stored in Glance. Glance just maintains a registry of the images, virtual images. And the virtual images are stored in Swift. So Swift is an object storage component of OpenStack. Then we have Neutron, which is the networking component of OpenStack. So for example, you have 2-3 VMs and then you want to configure a network, and you launch an instance of a VM and then you want to give assign it an IP and then you want to assign a port to it, that is done by Neutron. Next we have Cinder. So Cinder is used to attach volumes to the instances of VM. So it's kind of a file system attachment to your VMs. So So when you want to have some storage attached to your instances, you use Cinder. So you can attach any amount of volume to your instance and you can detach the volume as well using Cinder. Then we have RabbitMQ. This is a messaging queue service which is used internally by all the OpenStack services. So the OpenStack services communicate with each other using the RabbitMQ queue. So for example, there are two services and one service wants to send something to another service or request something to another service. It puts the request in the queue. It works by publishing and subscribing model. So the services which are subscribed to that particular request get the notification from the RabbitMQ queue and then it proceeds. So this is the architecture of OpenStack. So we'll take an example. So for example, you say that launch an instance of a VM via OpenStack. So what will you first do? You'll go to the Horizon dashboard. We'll see everything in action later. So right now, just imagine with me. So you go to the Horizon dashboard. You enter the credentials. The credentials go to the Keystone API. So this is the Keystone API which authenticates everything. So your credentials go to the Keystone API. It authenticates you as a user and it gives you a token. So using that token, you will do all other requests. So Keystone also saves your token and you also get the token. So what Horizon does is it maintains that token in the session, and whenever any request from Horizon is whenever you send any request from Horizon, then that along with that request, that token is passed so that Keystone can authenticate further. So for example, so you are authenticated now, so you get the access to the dashboard. Now you go inside the Horizon dashboard and you say launch an instance. So first of all, the call to launch an instance go to the Nova API. So Nova is a very big component. It has different services. So the service which is exposed to Horizon or the rest of the services is Nova API. The rest of the services are used internally by Nova itself. So the call from Horizon API comes to the Nova API that now launch this instance. So now what Nova will do is Nova doesn't know what image to use for launching that instance. So it tells Glance. So it asks Glance. So what is the image which I should use to launch that particular instance? So from Nova to Glance, the service request is passed through the API. So every service has a REST-based web service which is exposed. So Nova calls the REST-based web service exposed by Glance, and it asks Glance which image should I use to launch this particular instance. So what Glance will do is first it will authenticate Nova's request. So whether it has permission to launch a particular instance, then it will move ahead. So suppose it has permission to launch the particular instance, then Glance will ask Swift to get the image, to give it the image. So the images are stored in Swift. So Glance gets the image, and the information regarding this is stored in a queue, which is used internally by all the OpenStack services. So now Nova knows which image to use. Image part is done. The second is it wants to configure network on that instance. So it asks Neutron. So what network, what port should the VM use, and what IP should it be assigned? So it asks Neutron to configure the network details. Neutron does it and sends the request back to Nova. And the networking part is done. Then the third important part comes is attaching volume to that instance. So for the data to get stored, we need volume to be attached to that instance. So Nova calls Cinder, and Cinder attaches volume to that particular instance. So once all of this is done, so the request goes to all the APIs, and all the APIs sends the response back, and the responses are stored in the queue. So what Nova does is it fetches from the queue the required information. So it has got what which image it needs to use to spawn a VM, and what kind of network it has to configure, and volume attachment also part it gets. So once Noah gets all this, it asks the hypervisor to launch a particular instance. So while launching the particular instance, what Neutron does is, so Neutron has sent the response back to Noah that you can launch this particular instance. So Noah has launched a particular instance. Neutron will attach the network to it. Sender will attach volume part to it, and the image will be used from the Swift via Glance API. So that is how the VM will get spawned. So we'll see everything of this in action when we have the dev stack installed. So did you guys get me? As in, what doubts you have? So do you guys get the basic components, what each service does? So
what was the Saliometer?
So Saliometer is a monitoring service. So for now we can skip it. It monitors how much volume you can attach to your instance and the accounting part of the stack. So we need not get into that. So for development we need the rest of the components which I talked about. Did you guys get something at least? Or should I repeat the flow again?
I think it was good.
Okay. Sorry, go ahead. And so now I'll tell you about the dev stack, which is the open stack development environment.
Okay, so dev stack is the open stack development environment. It is basically it is the best place for developers and newbies to you know get started with OpenStack. So what we'll see is we've actually to try out OpenStack, you'll be using a virtual machine. You'll be essentially using a virtual machine. And why do you use a virtual machine? Is because DevStack essentially consists of scripts. And those scripts would be modifying your system configuration files, your network configuration files. And so if you don't want to mess up those configuration files in your system, you'd want to do that on a virtual machine. So that's why we need a virtual machine. And also,
he has a question.
Are you saying a virtual machine?
Yes.
I kept hearing it as an Ubuntu machine.
Okay.
I
said a virtual machine.
I get it.
Okay. Other than that, the other reason why we use a virtual machine is because you can save a snapshot of your virtual disk image, and then you can probably use it later. So what we have right now is that we have a VDI. I think you guys should be having it. On that VDI, we have the base Debian system, and on top of that, we have cloned the DevStack repo in that VDI.
You cloned all the codes.
Yes. Codes. So I explained that further. Can you go back and show? You are link. You log link. So Akansha is writing a blog, and on that blog, if you want to, you know, start from scratch, like installing the base operating system, and on top of that, you want to get clone, and then you want to try it out yourself, you can refer to this blog. It has a nice, simple blog post on how do you do that. Right now, in your VDIs, you'll have it already done. Okay. So DevStack essentially consists of scripts that help you. It's the easiest way to get your OpenStack development environment running, right? So you have these scripts. The most important of these scripts is stack.sh. What stack.sh will do is that it will. As Akansha explained, there are various components to OpenStack. So this script fetches those components, the code from the Git repos. It fetches it, and then it does all the configuration that is needed. The network configuration and everything else that is needed will be done by stack.sh. And other than that, Ashu was explaining that you have different components in OpenStack, and each component has a service. It has a service through which you can interact with the OpenStack component. Okay. So what this stack.sh script will do is that it will start all those services, and you will have your stack up and running. Also, one more important thing is that by default we use the stack.sh file. The default configuration is that you will have services of Nova, Cinder, yes. Horizon, Swift, all of these would be enabled.
Keystone
as well would be enabled by default. If you want some more services of other components, then there's a file called local.conf. In that file, you'll have to enable those services before you do a stack.sh. And also, there are also options for username and password that you'll need to set up in the local.conf file so that it does not ask you for your username and password again. Once that is done, we'll see how to do that. You'll do a stack.sh, and then that will give you a Horizon URL with which you can log in, and then you can create your instance and do other stuff. So we'll see that.
Okay, so in the meanwhile,
so in the meanwhile, as I explained, you need your services up and running. For that, you use the stack.sh. To stop those services, you'll be using the unstack.sh script. And if you have closed your virtual machine instance, and later you would want to restart those services that you had previously started using stack.sh, you would want to use the rejoin.stack. If at any point your stack opens, they've set up messes, if things are not installing up properly, you can do a clean.sh, and then you can do a stack.sh.